Hey everyone, Sam from Professional Music Technology here, and in this video we're taking a look at the main differences between four of Fender's most iconic bass guitar designs. So that's the Precision Bass, the Jazz Bass, the Mustang Bass, and finally the Jaguar Bass. Now these legendary basses have spawned countless copies and imitations, but nothing quite beats an authentic Fender. So for the examples in this vid, I'm going to be using a P bass and a Jazz bass taken from the new American Professional 2 series. We've got a Mustang PJ bass, which takes the classic Mustang bass design but adds more versatile pickup options. And then a Player Series Jaguar bass. So both the Jaguar and Mustang are more affordable mid-range options coming out of the Fender Mexico factory. Now, over the years, certain specs have varied slightly. So things like the types of woods used, the hardware, so we're talking about the bridges and the tuners, etc. And even the pickup configurations may vary from model to model. But there are a few key specifications that always remain pretty consistent, and these kind of define what makes each of these basses so unique. So if you were a little unsure, hopefully this video can help you decide which one's the right model for you. So the first specification that we're going to look at is scale length. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, the scale length on a guitar or a bass is the distance between the nut up at the headstock and the bridge down on the body. When it was first released back in 1951, the Precision Bass featured a 34-inch scale length, which was actually much shorter than the upright double basses of the time, which were usually around about 43 inches. And this is now generally considered to be the standard scale length for a bass guitar. The Jazz and Jaguar basses also share that same 34-inch scale in common, but the Mustang, however, is what's known as a short scale bass, as it's got a 30-inch scale length. When they first came along in the 1960s, the Mustang bass and its variants, the Music Master and Bronco basses, were marketed as more affordable kind of student models. So the thinking behind that shorter scale length is that it would make them easier to play for beginners or younger players, as you don't have to stretch quite as far to get down to the first few frets. A short scale length also means that there's slightly less tension on the strings when tuned to the same pitch as the longer basses, so the strings are also a little easier to fret and bend when you're first starting out. It's also worth bearing in mind that if you're ever replacing the strings on any of these basses, you need to make sure you pick up a set of long scale strings for either the P bass, Jazz bass, or Jaguar, or a short scale set for the Mustang bass. But if you are confused with all of the choices available, just ask any of the guys at your nearest PMT store and they'll be happy to help. Next up, and probably the most noticeable difference between all of these basses, is the shape of their bodies. When Leo Fender originally designed the Precision Bass, it was loosely based on the Telecaster electric guitar, with the main difference being the double cutaway. This was what actually inspired the design of the legendary Stratocaster, which came along a couple of years later, and that was when the P Bass was upgraded to add the same kind of body contouring as the Strat, to help make them a little more comfortable to play. The next model to arrive was the Jazz Bass, which was kind of a bass counterpart to the Fender Jazzmaster guitar, offering an arguably sleeker and sexier look than the P Bass. The Mustang Bass quickly followed, inspired by the Mustang guitar, which along with its shorter scale length features a much more compact and lighter body than the Jazz and Precision. And finally, stylishly late to the party when it was introduced into the range in the early 2000s, the Jaguar Bass is similar in size and weight to the P and Jazz Bass, but its shape is very similar to that of the Jaguar electric guitar, so it's not quite as curvy and has a less pronounced lower horn. When looking at the bodies, besides the Mustang's smaller size, the biggest difference between the Precision and the other three basses is that the Jazz, Jaguar and Mustang feature what's known as an offset body design. If you were to look at a P bass straight on and imagine cutting it in half, you'll notice that from the waist section downwards it's pretty symmetrical. An offset body, however, shifts the axis of that waistline a little, so the two halves of the body become less symmetrical and appear slightly offset against each other, hence the name. This was designed to help the bass sit a little more ergonomically in your lap, with the idea being that they should be easier and more comfortable to play when sitting down. But it does also shift the weight of the bass very slightly, so when you're standing up using a strap, an offset style bass will often naturally hang with the neck pointing a little more upwards. But it really is down to you which body style you prefer the feel of. So moving on, the next thing we're going to compare is the neck profiles, fingerboard widths and how they actually feel to play. Now, this is one of the things that has varied the most throughout the different models over the years, as Fender have experimented with different neck shapes and fingerboard radiuses. But what has remained relatively consistent is that a jazz bass will usually have a slimmer feeling profile than a P bass. And the width of the fingerboard at the nut will be noticeably thinner on a jazz bass. So in general, a J bass neck usually feels less chunky than a P bass and arguably a little more comfortable, easier and faster to play, especially if you've got smaller hands. The Jaguar Bass's neck is a kind of blend of the two, with a similar profile to the P bass, but with the same thin and nut width as the jazz. And as you might expect, to match its short scale and reduced body size, the neck on the Mustang Bass feels the smallest and easiest to get your fingers around, as you play up the frets, the fingerboard doesn't get quite as wide as on the other models. So that's scale length, body design and neck profiles. The final big difference between our four basses is their pickups and electronics. Now, again, the actual pickups and internal components will vary hugely from model to model, depending on which series and era the bass is from. But in their standard configurations, a precision bass will feature just the one split single coil pickup with a volume and a tone control, whilst a jazz bass offers a few more tonal options with its two single coil pickups, each with independent volume control, so you can blend between the two. When combined with the tone control, that single pickup on the P bass is actually more versatile than you might first think. Because of its hum cancelling split design, this type of pickup has been described as kind of not quite a single coil, not quite a humbucker. And when you combine this with its positioning slap bang in the middle of the body, it offers a really punchy tone with loads of mid-range bite, equally at home playing rock or punk music as it is for something like Motown or funk. Comparison, the mid position pickup on a jazz bass offers a smooth, warm bass tone, but usually with a little less bite than a P bass. But this can be compensated for by introducing the bridge pickup into the mix to add a honkier, treblier element to the tone. So when combined with the master tone control, the jazz bass's pickups can be blended to suit pretty much any musical genre, especially loved by funkier bass players, as that bridge pickup offers a little more pop, great for slapping techniques. Now, as the Jaguar Bass is generally seen as kind of a modern hybrid design, it actually employs the best of both worlds. So you get the P Bass's split single coil in the middle position, and the Jazz Bass's standard single coil at the bridge, again with independent volume controls and a master tone. With the exception of the additional three-way selector switch, the same goes for the Mustang model that we're looking at today. That's the Mustang PJ Bass. Now, unfortunately, I haven't actually got an original spec Mustang bass to demo for you today, although Fender do still make one as part of their Vintera series, which features a traditional single split coil pickup for if you did want that more kind of vintage sounding, raw, growly bass tone. The pickups on this more popular Mustang PJ bass, however, produce a fuller and more refined tone, and it totally makes sense why Fender have upgraded them, as you still get the compact, short scale feel of a Mustang, but now combined with the punch of a Precision and the tonal versatility of a jazz bass. So there we go, that's kind of the main factors that you're probably going to want to consider if you're deciding between the Precision, Jazz, Mustang and Jaguar basses. As I mentioned before, the Mustang PJ bass is a great option if you prefer the lighter, more compact feel of a short scale bass but don't really want to sacrifice tone. But all of these do offer something slightly different, and it will really come down to a personal preference based on how each one feels and sounds to you, and of course which one you think looks the best. So let us know your favourites in the comments below, and if you're still undecided, get down to your nearest PMT store and try a few out for yourself. For more information on our full range of Fender basses and all the different variations available, visit pmtonline.co.uk, and don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram as PMT House of Rock. So thanks for watching. As always, if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, ring the notifications bell, and I'll see you next time.